2:30 in the morning and I get a text from my friend. She said I need you right now and I already knew what that meant. See, me and this girl, we think alike. Too many phone calls spent for me to know she's thinking about a life and how it's gonna end. See, on the outside we're happy and we show it to the world, and we put on this fake exterior so the truth won't unfurl. But I know who she is, cause it's like looking in a mirror. All these smiles and cries for help and it couldn't be any clearer. So I pick up the phone and call her as she answers through her cries. She's hyperventilating, telling me that she wants to die. My heart starts to race and my thoughts begin to blur. We're 9 hours apart, but I'm seconds from losing her. I try to calm her down and tell her what she means to me. Even though we're new friends, she's seen a side that no one sees. Told her, listen to my breaths, I'm right here, please breathe. You got so much left to do, stay here, don't leave. The cries got even louder as the breaths got short. I told her, listen to my words as I fell down to the floor. Stay with me, I'm here, let it out, it's okay. Just cry till you can't cry, no more tears down your face. A couple minutes went by and the crying finally stopped. But not because she did, because the phone call dropped. I called her back quick, just hoping I'd hear hello. But I just kept getting met with the sounds of those dial tones. I froze. What do you do in that moment? Do you call the police? Or do you hope that she's over it? Get a hold of her parents and tell them the situation, just so they can pull her from college and end her aspirations. Leave it alone and hope it was just an escapade. Pray from a text from her in the morning saying that she's okay. Call anyone you know just to make sure that she's alive. Ignore it completely and pray to God that she survived. I let it go. She must have wanted to be alone. I guess that this was just another one of her episodes. She never told no one about this depression she dealt with, and who was I to air out her secrets? That would be selfish. So I lay down in my bed and I rested my head, closed my eyes and drifted peacefully to sleep. Then I dreamt that I would see her tomorrow and I would speak to her then, till I was woken to several missed calls and texts that she's dead. My heart broke. She downed a bottle of pills. She took them shortly after our call ended and it felt surreal. She was a friend of many, a student athlete at her school, a daughter, a sister, a very special jewel. At the funeral they told us that nobody had a clue that they could have saved her life, if only that they knew. And if someone at the funeral had ever felt depressed, to get some help so that your face won't ever end up in the press. There wasn't a dry face in the room, only 22 years old, an entire life in front of her, and now she's laying there cold. If only I'd called someone, we wouldn't be here now, and nobody would be sad, and I wouldn't feel like I let her down. But that's not what happened, cause instead of going to bed, I called every person I knew to check to make sure you weren't dead. I stayed up 7 hours praying every second of it, just hoping to get a text saying that you weren't heaven sent. But then I got it. You told me that I had no right and blocked me on everything, and we ain't talked since that night. Was I a bad friend? Options? I had none. I guess I'd rather be a bad friend than a sad one.